Hey guys, I'm Prithviraj from PR75K, and in some of my videos many of you commented on how I color grade my videos or asked me to make a video on color grade. So I'll be telling you how you can color correct your videos and make them look more cinematic. The video editor I'll be using is Adobe Premiere Pro. So if you're new to it, then you can just comment down below because I'm thinking of making a complete basics of Premiere Pro. So if you want that video, do let me know in the comment section down below. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel because I'll be making more such videos. And follow me on Instagram as well for behind the scenes and other fun stuff. I have a few footages over here. Now open Premiere Pro and let me just quickly import the footages over here. So let me just quickly drag one of these footages, for example this one. And let me just mute the track because I don't want the audio playing. As you can see, this footage is from a wheat field. Double click on your projects tab and hit on new item and click on adjustment layer. And you can change the settings if you want to. Resize it. So make sure your adjustment layer is selected. Now to color correct it, go and hit this option called color. If this window is not there, then just go to window, workspaces, and from there click on color. You can do any of them you want. So first thing I like to do is to get that cinematic orange and teal look. I most of the time edit on the color curves. So for example, let me first work on the highlights so I can make this a bit yellowish or orangish. So the more you go towards the end, it's more strong. So I prefer keeping it somewhere here in the middle. So I get that sweet orangish tint. And for the midtones, I'll be bringing it towards the bluish section or the tail look or whatever you call. And just play around with it and see which effects look good. You can play around with the shadows as well, but I won't be touching the shadows for this case. Now you can just go to curves. So if you're familiar with the tone curves from Adobe Lightroom or Photoshop, then this one is quite easy for you. So this one is goes from the dark to the highlights part. So this one is the blacks and this one is the whites, I mean. So if you just play around with the shadows a bit and the highlights a bit, you can just adjust the curve accordingly. And maybe if you can do it for the selective colors, for example, I'm using it for red. You can either make the reds pop out more or even decrease it as per your wish. I'll just keep it a bit subtle and I won't be messing with the greens and the blues over here. Now for this thing, we'll just do some basic color correction. So you can use the look over here. There are several presets over here. You can use custom presets if you have it on your computer. I'll be talking about that in a while. But for now, let's just take any preset. You can navigate the presets from here and when you like some of them, just click it over here and it will apply the preset. Now it might be too strong or too weak, so you can adjust the intensity a bit and the vibrance over like this, so I get that faded kind of look. And I like to decrease the saturation down a bit, so I get this kind of look over here. So this one is my favorite. If your footage is a bit low light or taken in the dark, then you can take most of its advantage with this filter called faded fill. It kind of gives a matte finish of white over it. Filmmakers generally spend the least amount of time color correcting. This is because they all have their settings saved as a preset, which is called a LUT. LUT stands for lookup table, so you can use that. There is a ton of free LUTs you can download from the internet. Now select your adjustment layer. And from this creative tab over here, go to look and click on browse. From there, go to the destination where you have saved the LUT and just select it and open it. So it will automatically apply the changes for you. As you can see, it was so damn simple. With just a few clicks, your footage got color graded. Now you can adjust many things over here if you want to. For example, I can give it a soft touch or quite a harsh touch if I want to. So it's just basically up to you. I'll just leave it over here. So that's pretty much it guys. So hope this video will help you color correct. And you can get ton of LUTs online. So just simply search free LUTs on Google or YouTube or whatever. You'll get ton of them. don't forget to subscribe to my channel because it does help me a lot. And I'll catch you in the next one. Till then, hasta la vista.